Hello everybody, welcome to Business Communication with me, Dr. Premanand. Today we are going to talk about the meaning, the need, the process and the methods of business communication. By the way, business communication is found in the University of Calicut Master of Business Administration syllabus, BUS 1C01, and its course objectives are to understand the process of business communication, acquire, manage business communication, to give awareness about and to help develop the personality of students studying business communication. If you need any help or require any assistance in video lessons, please do contact me. Business communication is the process of sharing information between people within and outside a company. Effective business communication is how employees and management interact to reach organizational goals. The purpose of business communication is to improve organizational practices and, of course, to reduce errors. Business communication involves constant flow of information. Feedback is also an integral part of business communication. So these days, organizations are very large and they require a large number of people. Naturally, there will be levels of hierarchy in an organization, and greater the number of levels, the more difficult it is for the job of a manager to manage the organization. And it is here that communication plays a very important role in the process of directing and controlling the people in the organization. So, the need for business communication, because communication is one of the most important functions of management. It can cement an organization or it can even disrupt the whole organization. It will promote managerial efficiency and induce the human elements in an organization to develop a sort of cooperation between the manager and the employees. And it is one of the most vital factors in the performance of a management. And we know that if business communication needs to improve, it should be efficient and smooth running. The company should, you know, run efficiently and smoothly. There should be proper planning and coordination. The morale building of the company should be great, and the binding of people together, the higher echelons of management and the lower rung of management, they should all bind together, thus creating a sense of mutual trust and confidence. So this is basically the need for business communication, to create a mutual trust and confidence. Now, in the process of business communication, according to Mr. Kretner, business communication is a process and is a chain made up of identifiable links. This link or this chain includes the sender, the message, encoding, a receiver, decoding, and feedback. A detailed review of this is given in the link below. Please do have a look at that too. The types of business, there are two types of business communication. One is the internal communication and the second is the external communication. So when you broadly categorize business communication, it can be classified into two business type communication systems, namely internal communication and external communication. Now, in internal communication, you have upward communication, wherein the information is transmitted by a member or by the entire staff to the hierarchy. So it goes upward. It could also be like, it can be like an idea or a information or a feedback or some sort of an enthusiasm. So this goes up. This is an example of upward communication. Let's say an activity report that one person submits directly to the manager. And this is a sort of upward communication. Now, in downward communication, the information is transmitted higher from a hierarchically superior person to a subordinate, and generally this is found in the army. The downward communication takes place if there is a upward communication. Once the hierarchy is built, then it's easy to take communication downwards. And basically, these downward communication depends on instruction, giving instructions, or to circulate vital information, or to boost morale, or to increase effectiveness. This is all basically downward communication. For example, suppose a service manager submits a work order to an employee. So this is sort of downward communication. And horizontal communication, the transmission is on a horizontal plane. For example, a colleague to colleague. Now here, there is no hierarchy. It is basically on a plane level. So this would be something like, solving a problem for the other person, or accomplishing a task mutually, or a teamwork. These are all sort of horizontal communication. So in internal communication, it can be divided into three: upward communication, downward communication, and horizontal communication. In the external communication, so as I mentioned before, we have internal communication and external communication. So in external communication, it is basically the building and a maintaining of a positive relationship with the media. Media relations and external events, company spokesmen, website and apps are all examples of external communication. So the media relations, when you establish a good relationship with the media, either the television or the print or the radio or the web, all this, that sort of a positive relationship building is one sort of external communication. It could also be through external events. You could have a product promotion. It could be a seller's meeting. It could be a supplier's meeting, channel partner meeting, and things like that. So this, let's say you need to launch a major product, or maybe an initiative, and these things, come under external events. You can also have a sort of company spokesman who talks on your behalf, who is a person maybe in authority and well respected in that particular sector. That person would act as your brand ambassador, and that is also another form of external communication. Also, websites and apps these days act as your external communication. So your website address or your app address will take your company forward, and these are examples of external communication. So media relations, external events, company spokesman, and website or apps are examples of external communication. Now, in methods of business communication, you have verbal communication, you have written communication, you have electronic communication. These are just three. There are much more. The verbal communication is a way where one person transfers information to another person through verbally. And this can be either through a telephone message or a discussion or a video conferencing and things like that. Now, the written communication would be when one person writes, or one person specifies an email or a formal letter or a poster to another person. So this is the sender and the receiver concept is basically known as written communication. And electronic communication, which is the development of new technologies and presently the fastest growing, is wherein the sender sends information through emails or social media or text or blogs or website. So these are different methods of business communication, and of course there are still more. For example, non-verbal communication, that is there in the link below. Please do look into that also, and of course please do subscribe to our channel, because more and more information keeps getting into you. And please do comment, because your comment takes us higher and higher. So thank you very much, and have a great day.